Guys, welcome to the Life Without Taffy Show. This is episode number 46. My name is Josh. This is my wife, Kate. Kate, looking at more makeup classes online?
Well, I was watching a video on contouring, and then my internet ran out, so this is as far as I got.
You used up your minutes?
Yeah.
You only got the 20 hours on AOL,
right.
So then you ran out.
Yeah, I was right in the middle. Like, I think there was one more step and I would have been done, but...
No, I think that's good. Well, I was going to say, if you had a problem with your glitter not showing up last week or the week before, I think this is definitely going to show up. Like it or not, it's going to happen. Here we go.
Good night.
It's Barrel Hitch American Whiskey. We just finished another bottle. So that was the last of that.
Ouch.
No, it's okay.
Ooh.
Was that not...
Ooh.
She's a wolf. You guys, she's a wolf. It's probably fine. She's not with the Hoegaarden. Belgian wheat beer.
I'm having Portland Cider's own Portland Cider. Very good. Drink it. It's good.
Yeah, drink it. It's drinks.
Oops. I think I messed up my makeup. My face is so itchy.
Please don't itch your face. So, let's start as we usually do. I should have said this before. The credits would have told you that. This is the food and drink episode, you guys.
Yay.
We're doing a theme. This is all food and drink based.
For the most part, yeah. I'm sure there will be tangents.
There's always tangents. We're drinking drinks. So, do you have a food or drink related grievance for this week?
Yeah.
I forgot my Brett, so I'm going to be playing with my hair all the time.
Do you
Sorry,
grab your
guys.
Brett?
No.
You want to use my Brett?
The one with the hat on it? No, you gotta keep that. Dear grievance, I'm gonna go get... I gotta put my hair up. I'm turning into a little emo boy. You need to cut my hair again. Look at this. What is this? What is this? You did that. I'm very emotional!
You need some eyeliner. I can do your makeup.
I may take you up on that. You got a good look going. Do you have a food or drink-related grievance?
Yeah.
Not necessarily this week, but just in general.
This is in general.
So... I'm just going to change my shirt. I feel bad.
Yeah, you don't care much about this, do you?
Well, it's our words.
Is it? But why are we doing it on video, then?
Because people like watching videos. They don't like listening to something. They want to see us react.
I guess. Whatever.
I'm that. You're going to smudge it.
Fuck.
That's fine. Do you have... a food or drink related grimace?
Yes.
What do you got?
So I found some organic Starbursts at the store a while back, and they're really tasty, and I love them a lot, but there's citric acid in them, and so it's like leaving little like sores on my tongue and side of my cheeks and stuff. It's just because I eat too many.
Yeah, don't eat it. It's like, hey, Sour Patch Kids, let me eat a pound. I don't want my mouth to work anymore.
Same concept.
Yeah.
Or Sweet Tarts or any of those other things with lots of citric acid in them. But, yeah. I have a couple today. They burn.
That's no good.
It's worth it. The price is worth it.
Speaking of prices that are worth it, my grievance is against lactose. Why are you in all the things that are great? My tummy is a jerk.
Yeah.
But you know what? Pizza's real, so I eat that. Who cares? Sorry, butthole.
Pizza's real?
Yeah.
Well, yeah.
Yeah. So I gotta eat pizza.
Okay.
Even if my tummy goes, uh-uh!
But the thing is it says, uh-uh, like a lot later, right? It's not like instantaneous.
It depends.
Really?
It depends on what kind of pizza we eat.
Really?
Or how many tacos I eat, or how many anything.
You don't even put that much cheese on your tacos.
Well, I put cheese on there, and then I put sour cream, and then there's beans, and then it all whips up into some cool butt action.
Beans are not dairy.
We should name the show Cool Butt Action. We get more hits.
Beans are not dairy.
No, I know, but I'm saying my tummy's already going to be weird because of that. And then it adds it to the other stuff. Tummy. Speaking of the guy who just ate a bowl of chili. Cool guy.
I'm the one who's got to live with you. Why do you think I keep opening the windows even though it's like 2 degrees outside?
It's definitely not 2 degrees. Is that Kelvin?
It's going to be cold next week.
I know it is. It's, you know, 40s is fine.
39, 34.
Oh, 34 isn't great.
That'll be the low though. It's not the high.
Well, okay.
Yeah.
I'm glad it's cold enough. I'm just going to keep my hands in my pockets.
I have mine down here. Here,
you're such
do this.
You're such a gentleman.
Well, I just came from my office job.
What do you do in your office?
A lot of that.
What?
I don't know. That.
What is that? No, you could do it again. That doesn't explain what it is.
Just tightening my tie.
Tightening. Oh, I thought you were loosening.
Oh, that would be this, right?
I don't know.
I was doing this.
I don't know. You're doing both at the same time somehow. I don't know how that works.
I just came from my office job learning how to contour.
That makes sense.
Makeup contouring.
Maybe you'll learn it tomorrow.
Maybe. No, because our AOL CD doesn't come for another 2 weeks.
Because you need to use a new CD every time. You gotta keep it in there, and it spins.
Yeah.
Not sure how that works.
Me neither. Yeah, you should dance with me. Or just steal my moves. It's fine. Whatever.
That's one of your moves?
Yeah.
That's crazy. For our special food and drink related episode, top 5 foods and drinks that you used to enjoy, but do not any longer.
Mm-hmm.
Do not have anymore. How about that?
Don't eat anymore. Yeah.
You could probably still enjoy it, but you don't have it anymore.
Not necessarily.
Well, let's go for it.
Okay.
What do you got?
You first.
No?
I went first last time.
It doesn't matter. Go ahead.
No, you first.
I need to go second. Thank you.
Such a drama queen.
No, I...
Alright, number 5.
I am, but no.
Apparently, this is something that I've been told. I ate a lot of applesauce when I was a kid. And
kids love applesauce.
My parents tell me that I used to eat it all the time, but I haven't eaten it since I can remember. I just never really liked it. It's just like...
I used to get the, in my lunch, I would get the little cups.
Right.
But I would never get a spoon, so I just either use the lid or I just go...
That's gross.
Yeah.
That's really gross.
It's applesauce. Just eat it. Who cares? Number 4.
I have something written down here that I'm not sure makes any sense.
Just skip that.
Oh, okay. Well, it would have segued into lunches. Packed lunches.
Okay, you can still do that.
But it's not part of top 5.
Okay.
You asked me to write down my favorite cookie.
No, not necessarily. I mean, if that's a thing you miss, yeah.
No, it's just...
Do you not understand the segment? Or are you just like...
Anyway, number 4.
Is this another tangent?
Yes.
Go ahead. What kind of cookie do you like?
So,
this is not a 5.
No, this is not a 5.
Okay.
It's just that I used to get these in my lunch, too.
Yeah?
Do you remember the Keebler cookies that had, like, the little rainbow, the M&Ms in them?
Yeah.
But they were, like, not M&M colors. They were, like, orange and, like,
yeah, those,
a weird
rainbow
blue.
Rainbow Chips Deluxe.
Yeah.
Duh.
I used to get this. My dad would pack those for me in my lunch
all
the time.
Those are good.
Yeah.
I could eat some of those.
I want my dad to pack my lunch one of these days. I should call him and ask him to pack my lunch.
Dad, if you're watching...
Jesus, no, Dad's not watching.
Sorry, Dad.
Sorry, Dad. Number 4. Sugary cereals.
Okay.
I used to eat those all the time.
What are your favorites?
Let's go down
the list.
Probably Cinnamon Toast Crunches at the top.
Sure.
Cocoa Puffs.
Yeah.
Frosted Flakes.
Can I say something?
Yes.
I'm going to out you in front of the internet community. All these delicious cereals... The milk at the end is great.
I don't drink the milk at the end.
Kate doesn't drink the milk at the end of the bowl of cereal
because
she's
attempt,
a fucking monster.
In an attempt not to waste the milk, I put in just enough so that there's no milk at the end. That way I'm not wasting it, but I don't like it.
Drink the milk.
No.
Slam it.
I don't like strawberry milk. I don't like chocolate milk. I don't like any of
You don't
of
like chocolate things. Milk?
I don't like chocolate milk.
What?
I've never liked chocolate milk.
That's crazy.
Sorry.
You used to get banana milk.
I don't like that either.
You ever have banana quick?
No.
That was one of my go-to 7-Eleven drinks in high school.
No.
Banana Quick.
Nope.
Definitely don't
like
that anymore.
I don't like flavored milk.
But you like ice cream.
That's different.
It's flavored milk.
It's not liquid. I don't like the ice cream at the end that's all melted. I have to eat as fast as I can.
And you eat all the noodles out of your soup and then you just throw the broth away.
Yeah, I do.
No! Do you? I was just kidding!
It depends on the soup, to be honest. But yeah, sort of.
Damn it.
Oopsies. Number three.
Yeah.
Hot dogs. I don't eat those anymore. Because every single last time I've had a hot dog, I've thrown up. So
there's unrelated. I think the problem was, for a long time, the only time we would eat hot dogs is when we've been drinking too much.
I've had them in between and they just made me sick.
When?
I would try and get the, like...
Name 15 times you've had a hot dog.
The first time.
Yeah.
The second time.
Shh.
The third time.
Okay.
The fourth time.
Yeah, I remember that.
The fifth time.
Yeah.
The sixth time. The seventh time, the eighth time, the eight and a half time, I'm counting that one as a throw up one, so I threw it up, the ninth time, the ninth and a half time, the tenth time,
yeah.
The 11th time, 12, and then 13, 14, 15 were all 13, 14, 15, and 13 and a half, 14 and a half, 13 and a half, and that's pretty much where I cut it off.
That was worth it. That was definitely worth it.
Every kind of way. I've had it sliced into like macaroni.
When you were 5 years old.
I've had it fried on the pan. I've had it grilled. I've had it microwaved. I've had it boiled. Boiled hot dog.
Sometimes you gotta eat a boiled hot dog. I get it.
If that's the only thing you have and you're starving to death, I guess. How do you feel about vegetarian hot dogs?
Those aren't hot dogs.
Right. They're just bean slabs.
They're definitely bean slabs, and that's what they call them.
Yeah. Number two. fast food. I don't...
What do you miss? What dishes do you miss from fast food?
Breakfast.
What specifically?
Like a croissant witch from, like, Burger King, or, like, a bacon, egg, and cheese biscuit from McDonald's, the hash browns.
Get the fucking, the pancake, the flapjack hotcake platter at McDonald's?
No.
Oh, that's awful.
No.
Oh, it's awful.
I had a McGriddle a couple of times, and it was really weird.
It was weird.
My problem isn't necessarily that they taste bad at the time. It's just that you end up eat one thing from fast food, and you're going to be, like, burping it up for, like, the next 72 hours, and it's just gross.
Burping if you're lucky.
Yeah, right. That's if it's not poison to begin with. But,
So you miss it.
No, actually I don't.
Kind of. So what's that face?
Nothing. Sorry.
What's number one?
Cheetos. I used to eat Cheetos all the time. Like, my fingers would be, like, perpetually... Oh, you've got something over here.
How long... Oh, hold on.
No. Oh my god, what have you done?
How long has it been since you've had a bag of original style Cheeto snacks? How long has it been?
Probably 5 or 6 years.
Here we go.
Oh, I have to try them now?
Yeah. Being a person who only eats organic fake cheese snacks, and you know,
my organic snacks are made with real cheese.
My theory is the only reason
I don't see that on here anywhere.
Hold on. The only reason I think organics have taken off is because they make fake versions of food we like.
It's not fake, it's more real. This is...
You know what I mean.
Here's
you know what I mean.
These are heavily processed,
if
so what I do is I choose the other ones that are less processed.
Sure,
that's
sure.
The only thing.
Right, but I'm saying, if they wanted you to eat healthy, they would make just healthier snacks. No, they have to make fake junk...
They already make healthy snacks. They're called vegetables.
You're right, but they have to make fake junk food to get normal people to eat the organic Cheetos. Organic.
It's for children.
These?
No, the all natural.
All
stuff.
The food that's in our cabinets and in our refrigerator right now.
Mhm.
That's true. Here we go.
God,
how do they smell?
They smell pretty good. They're more irradiated than I remember.
That's a bright color.
You know, and that's the other thing too, is that, like, I can see the bug parts. You know, because they allow a certain amount of, like, natural flavors to get in there.
I don't think it's necessarily a bug part.
I don't. Well, what would you call that?
It's just a burnt bit. They cook these. They're cooked.
They're not cooked. They're probably like alien dildos.
Eat it in your mouth! Don't put it back in! You can't finish one?
I'm not gonna eat that bug part.
Oh my god, give me the bug part.
They taste pretty much exactly as I remember them.
Well, that's fine.
They're okay.
Oh, I like this. What's a serving? This is a new thing they're putting on the back of the bag. With Cheetos brand Puff Snacks, eat 13. That's just the right amount for fun to the max. Who is not going to eat this whole bag in one sitting?
And this is 3.5 servings.
Bullshit. This is... I'll get into this in my list.
So there you go.
If you don't want those, I'll totally eat those. those are very tasty.
I haven't had the Puffs in a long time, but I had the Crunchies a little while ago. And I had a bag size like this because it was from a convenience store.
Mm.
I might have eaten like a third of the bag and said, I don't like this
That's
anymore.
Just the right amount. You ate your 13 and you're like, I'm full.
I got to the point where I was just like, no, I don't like this anymore. And I didn't eat the rest of it.
What'd you do with it?
Tossed it. This was months ago.
Bring it home.
Okay.
I will eat your trash.
I will probably have a couple for nostalgia, and then you can have the rest.
Done and done. I'll take them.
Okay. And yours?
I just need to get that out of the way.
Oh, okay.
Top 5. Food and drinks I used to enjoy, but I don't have them anymore.
Why?
I'll get into them.
Oh.
Gas station snacks. Up to and including...
What you just
going
bought?
No, I'm talking about going into 7-Eleven, get the nachos, get
the little pizza thing on the spinner.
Get the hot dog, get the taquito.
The taquitos.
Those fucking monsters.
Yeah, no, I liked those too.
Absolutely. Just load up, just fucking nachos. Just soak it. And then you eat like 4 chips and then it's all cold. And it's like, you eat it anyway because you bought it.
You bought it.
And you're the one who had to put 3 pounds of meat product in it.
Oh, yeah, mystery meat. Not great.
I'll eat it. Is there mystery meat in
those?
I'm
sure there is.
Number 4. This goes back to what I was talking about. This is me as a high school boy. Chips as meals. like I'm just going to eat this whole bag of Doritos and that's my lunch today.
like a regular size?
Like that size. Oh. I'd get one of those and then I'd get a soda. Like fucking like a weird, like a Minute Maid orange soda or something. Yeah, like real weird. They don't fit at all.
Yeah.
Just be an orange boy.
Oh, I used to drink orange soda with these.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
But it was good together.
They're color-coded.
Actually, my favorite high stuff was this and Code Red.
Yeah, they fight.
Mm-hmm. With a peanut butter and jelly sandwich, of course.
Why am I yawning? I'm sorry, guys. I'm even bored in myself.
Oh, wow.
Number 3, TV dinners.
Yeah, Hungry Man.
So you get my Hungry Man.
Your Lonely Man's.
My Lonely Man dinners. But I get like the 2.5 pounder or whatever. It just has all this bullshit in it.
Yeah. What was your favorite part of those? The brownie?
No. That's more of a banquet thing. But I used to eat those too.
Yeah. All did.
It's a whole meal for $1. Perfect.
I bet it's real healthy.
Not necessarily.
No?
Maybe.
You get the Salisbury steak.
I would like a Salisbury steak. Please.
That's a mystery meat if I ever seen one. That's a slab of meat if I'd ever seen one.
It's not even steak. What are you doing? Counting?
Yep, 15 times I barfed at Salisbury steak.
You've never had it.
You're right.
It's a shame. You're basically missing out.
I don't think that's true.
Basically.
I don't think so.
So, number 2. This goes along with yours. Fast food.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I kind of miss Taco Bell.
I'll eat fucking tacos all day long.
Yeah.
I think part of the reason we don't eat it anymore, because it's not near us. We have to go out to the fucking suburbs to get to fast food. The only fast food around here is going to be fucking Subway, and those are on every corner for whatever reason.
That's the weirdest thing I've ever seen.
But those aren't food.
No.
Don't eat Subway sandwiches.
It's not even, like, so it's not food, but it's
turkey
not...
should be gray.
It's not food, right? It's not food. It's just trash. But it's not even, like, taste good enough to be not food, like fast food is.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, I do get what you're saying.
Like, it's trying to be healthy, but it doesn't even taste good, so it's...
No, it's not great.
It's not healthy.
It's not great.
It's bad.
It's bad. It's bad. And number one, this is going back to my youth as well.
Oh boy. Is it Pop Rocks?
Domestic light beer. I cannot tell you how many of these I've had in my life. Hundreds and hundreds. Oh, this is a tall boy. Don't kid yourself. But I think one of the... What's wrong? Don't make that face. It's the Bud Light. How big is this? This is a big...
You're going to drink that?
Yeah, this is going in my face right now. I think I made a concerted effort moving out here to Portland where I wasn't going to drink this garbage anymore.
Well, we have local breweries.
Well, I know what I'm saying. I drink a Rainier every once in a while, which is, I guess, is basically the same thing. But it's, you know. But anyway, Bud Light, it's the most popular beer in America. Due to its advertising and...
I know, somebody's going to like this
sponsoring,
part. This
sponsoring
the
world. Where does it even say? 4.2 alcohol per volume. Per volume, though.
Oh, well, mine's 505.
What do we got here? 1.9 ounces. That's, yeah. 0.9 grams of protein.
Is that like 20?
What?
20 ounces?
Oh, I don't know. No, 25. 25 fluid. So this is like two beers and then a little bit at the end. Oh. Oh, boy. Oh, that smells bad. See, the problem is I've become what I hate. I'm a fucking beer snob now.
That's okay. You okay. It's not... You would never look at somebody and be like... Like, you wouldn't make a face at somebody who ordered a Bud Light at a bar, would you?
It depends on where you are, I guess.
No, you just don't.
It depends on where you are.
You don't, but whatever
you... It depends on where you are.
Whatever. I just...
My
get that face when I say, do you have any local ciders? Because, honestly, the other ciders are trash. It's trash, like that.
I think it's hilarious that the Cider House, the only beer they have is a Bud Light.
Because they don't want you to drink it!
But they have it because somebody buys it!
Somebody's like, oh, drink sir.
Here we go. It doesn't taste like anything. That's why I used to be able to drink thousands of these. It's water. It's water.
It's alcoholic water.
Yeah.
It's barley water.
Yeah. I don't... It's boring.
There's no hoppy notes, no citrus, no pine cones.
No, there's nothing. It's just nothing.
Trash.
Yeah, there's nothing to it.
Wow. Cool.
Cool.
Good thing you bought a giant one.
Well, it's either this or a multi-pack.
Oh, okay. That's fair.
So, because I was going to get Miller Lite, because that was my drink. But,
Well, what was your original drink?
Going way back, it was Milwaukee's Best. But that's because I was a nightmare and a monster and you can get you can get a 12-pack for $6.99. Oh. But that was a long time ago, guys.
Couple years.
More than a couple. To be fair, more than a couple.
Yeah.
So yeah, I'm going to drink the rest of this
I'm really glad you picked something that I don't have to try. Because I was starting to worry that you were like, you wanted to try one of these.
Come on, try it. I
don't drink domestic beer.
Portland is domestic.
That's craft beer.
For America. For America!
I haven't even had a hot dog.
You're not gonna throw
up.
You're not gonna throw up. No, it doesn't even smell like anything. So
yeah,
don't even pretend.
It smells like sewer water. See?
No,
thank you.
My nose is stuffed up, so I can't. It's got a wide mouth. It's got a wide mouth. You know what? If somebody brought these over to my house, I'd drink them. Well, I'm not going to buy them.
So you're not a snob. That would be snobby.
But I would never order this.
That's okay. You're allowed to not order things.
But you don't let me go to Buffalo Wild Wings, because that's what the boys drink.
We're not going to Buffalo Wild Wings ever. We never
Fuck.
Do that anyway. You want to get wings? We'll go to a wing house or whatever.
Kate.
A real one.
Part of this list was like, sometimes garbage is fun.
I get it.
Do you?
You want a hangover from those?
Hangover's a hangover.
Not for me.
Yeah.
The sugarier the drink?
Don't eat sugar drinks.
That's why I ask for local.
I almost got your hard lemonade, and I should have. That would have been funny.
Just a size
of these.
Oh no.
Just, yeah.
I'll die.
You've had them before.
I know, but I'll die. Okay, so I had to go from, like, not drinking to drinking, because I never used to drink at all. Like, at all.
Sorry.
The only way I was going to make it to drinking is that if I had, like, baby steps
sweet.
In between. So if I just had super sugar drinks and sangria
sweet
and things
mix.
Like that, yeah. Then I could work my way up to... Because these regular ciders, they're kind of an acquired taste.
Yeah, there's... You gotta fight with them a little bit. And I think that's why people have poo-pooed, like, the craft beer stuff. I get it. Some of them are sour or hoppy or whatever. I mean, there's... On any number of kinds of things. They're real chewy.
Or bitter
or whatever.
Right.
You know?
But you work your way up to things like that. And I've worked my way up to this. I'm not going back.
But there's a thing for everybody.
Right.
When people say they don't like beer, maybe you do.
No.
Maybe you do. If you're only going by this, you may not like beer because this isn't great. Let me drink some more of it.
How many different kinds of beer have you logged?
Hundreds.
And I still haven't found one?
You'll find one.
I still haven't found one. What I'm looking for.
Oh, come on. Cue the song.
I love that you know what I was going to say before I said it.
Of course I do. You love U2 as much as I do. Even if they're from England. Who gives a shit?
Totally shit.
That's true.
Yay. Is that all of them? Did you get them all?
Yeah, I did. Nice. Well, I had to end with this. Well, see, that's why I wanted to go first, so I could finish my good beer and then taint it with this trash. It's not bad. But I think it's one of those things, the more you drink it, it's like, not bad, man.
Was that the worst beer you've ever had?
Bud Light, no.
What's the worst beer you've ever had? Like Bud Light Platinum or whatever it was?
No, that was okay. I don't know if it's a worst type situation. I think
least
there's things
enjoyable.
I don't like. I think there's don't like. And like double IPAs I don't like. Because there's too much.
Uh-huh. Too much what?
Just too much pine needles.
Poppies?
Too much.
Poppy poppies?
But I also like some of like the real thick, heavy things I don't like either.
Oh, like stouts and junk?
Yeah, there's a couple of those that are like too much.
Yeah. Well, that's why you sip those. You don't chug those.
That's bullshit. I'll do what I want.
Fair enough.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Yay.
So that's top five.
Top five.
What comes next? Do you remember? You remember. Yes. Okay, I'm back to not liking this. But I know if it gets warm, it's over, so.
Ah, okay. Well, if you want to get up and get yourself something else, you can get me something, too.
I'll get you something. I know it's going to make me fucking gassy as hell.
You're already gassy as hell.
I know, that's going to... Do you need another one? Is that what you're saying?
I'm almost done.
Yeah.
Food-related yes or no's.
Food or drink related, yes or no?
Correct.
This week on the special food. God damn it. The special food and drink episode.
Hooray. Number one.
It's just sour water.
Yeah. Chocolate truffles.
Yeah. I'm going to say yes.
Good. That's the correct answer.
Yeah.
Because you know why?
Because you have some in the cabinet, and we're going to eat them right now!
Because I like them a lot, and Christmas is coming.
No, I'm going to get you a tin of popcorn if I'm getting you anything. Or I'm going to get you the little tin of Dutch cookies. Which one do you prefer?
Cookies. Cookers. I like cookers. Number two?
Yeah.
Cat food.
What?
Cat food.
I've eaten cat food on several occasions.
How'd you like it?
It depends.
Do you think ours tastes good?
I don't even like the way the kind you get now looks.
The pate-like stuff?
Ugh, gross. No, the one...
No, it mixes up better. Because we gotta mix it with veg.
Not for us. No, I'm saying, there was this one kind that was just, it just looked like shredded chicken. Let me try that. Nope, that tastes like poison death. Don't eat that.
No, we don't eat that.
So what are you asking? Should cat food exist? I don't know what the question is. What's the question?
Is cat food a necessity?
For cats, yeah.
Yes.
I don't... Is this... I don't know. Dog food!
No, that was the only goof.
Hummingbird food!
That was the only goof.
Goof food.
Have you ever had Wise chips? Like the owl?
Yeah.
Yeah. How do you feel about
them? They're fine.
Yes or no?
Yeah. It's a vending machine staple.
It's so gross. I remember...
They're not great.
A long time
but
ago.
But when you're in a pinch and those are only chips in there...
I got a sample of them in the mail one time.
What year is this?
Like 1922? I don't know.
That's...
Like 1985 or something?
When you're 1 year old, you get a bag of chips in the mail addressed to you specifically.
No, of course not.
What are you talking
about? I was a small child. Like, I couldn't have been more than 10. And we got them in the mail, like, as a sample, and
yeah.
I ate them, and they were fucking gross. They didn't have any salt. They were, like, hard as, like, fucking
so they were, like,
paint chips.
Kettle chips before you acquired that taste.
Harder than that. I remember them being, like, gross, thick, weird
How
chips.
How thick were they?
At least.
That doesn't seem right.
At least. I don't know if they were
You're
gross.
Just eating potatoes.
No, we got... I remember seeing them, because I had an owl on the front.
How can you trust any memory when you're 10 years old? I'm sure they're fine. I haven't had them in a long time, but that seems to be a chip that was in a couple of vending machines that I used to frequent. And occasionally I want just chips.
Just chips.
They
don't want something that's got 1,000 flavors?
Flavors I like, but sometimes I want a plain chip. If I want a bag of Lay's.
Yeah.
Or a bag of Ruff. Yeah, Ruffles are okay. I was going to say. Do I like Ruffles?
No.
I like flavored Ruffles.
Yeah, they're all gross. You like the sour cream and chives, don't you?
Sour cream and cheddar. Cheddar sour cream.
Oh, never mind.
It's the other way.
Probably tastes like Doritos.
I don't understand.
Every flavored chip tastes like Doritos.
That is not any kind of true. Even the pickle chips I get?
Yeah.
That's
incredible. No, those taste like... Okay, there's three kinds of chips.
Okay.
Plain, salt and vinegar, and every iteration of that.
Chocolate chips.
And... Dorito chips.
Dorito chips? It's not a style of chip.
It is. Every flavor.
If it's Doritos, yeah.
Anything with vinegar has its own distinct thing.
Yeah.
Like that. And then there's the other flavor chips. Everything that's got cheese or whatever. Ranch.
So cheese and ranch are the same.
They are.
What are you doing?
When they're in chip form.
Cheese and ranch are the same?
When they're in chip form.
What are you talking about? What's
they're totally
wrong with
different
mouth?
When they're actual things.
They're different in chaps.
They're not different in chaps.
You are crazy.
They're not. They all taste like Doritos.
We are
going to
do a blindfolded taste test. What kind of chip is this? Oh, they're all the same.
I'm going to say that.
Your palate's trash. We've already talked about this.
No, it's not. It may have been slightly destroyed from all the starbursts, but it's not trash. I can still taste things.
You don't know the difference between cheese and ranch? Crazy.
They all start with the same base,
yeah.
Weird flavor.
Potato!
No. The dust. The dust that goes off.
This guy!
Anyway.
Yeah.
Hot dog buns with poppy seeds on them.
No! What?!
That's Chicago style.
No, still no.
Right. That's weird. Don't put those on there, you guys. Oops, that's a yes, not an X.
It doesn't matter.
It doesn't.
Who's keeping score? Are you really?
No.
That's why I lose every time.
I lost my first book. I don't know. It's a clean slate.
Good.
You got 100% on the last one because it was all yeses.
No, I didn't do all yeses.
Yeah.
You did all yeses. And that didn't count.
Number whatever. 5. Mineral water.
No.
Correct.
What?
You know, like, people put, like, sulfur dioxide and sulfuric acid and, like, and MSG and stuff like that in their, like, sparkling water or whatever.
What is up with LaCroix these days, you guys?
I don't know.
That's fucking gross.
That exploded like crazy. It's just seltzer water.
It's gross.
Right.
It's gross.
It's not even, like, as good as club soda, which is
It's
just...
not anything. Don't drink that. It's not a flavor.
No, it's... They're pretty funky.
The anti-flavor is too much. It's like... It's just...
What flavor have you had?
Most of them.
What? Since when are you drinking them?
No, they just had some in the fridge at work.
Oh. Did you try one?
For a thing. Yeah. No, I mean, not the LaCroix, but one of the off-brand ones.
Oh, well, that's probably even worse.
Yeah, they're all bad. No, I've had LaCroix
like
before.
Kroger.
No, no, I mean, but one of the other brands of those stupid drinks.
Oh. Like Canada Dry or something?
Yeah, like Canada Dry.
draw a mustache on you.
Pause it so I can zoom in.
Zoom in!
Stop! What are you doing? So yeah, seltzer water is weird. Don't drink that.
Yeah.
We'll have some next week.
Number six?
Do you get one? I guess you can buy one.
One what?
Seltzer water.
Yeah.
We'll make you drink one next week. It's okay, I'm not writing this down, so it won't happen.
Okay, good. Don't buy...
We definitely need to... LaCroix. We should have just went to the store, like in the good old days, and then just go to 7-Eleven and buy all the things we would have bought 10 years ago. And then see what happens.
You don't get high anymore, so I feel
I don't. I'm high on life, you guys. Drugs are bad.
They're legal here. It's fine. Number six.
So that makes it less cool. I'll just be bloated on the fucking floor. That's got a taste.
Ugh, gross.
It's got a taste.
That's not a glowing review.
It's barley malt. It's the best barley malt, Kate.
That sounds awful.
It's fine.
It's probably all GMO. You're killing butterflies, goddammit.
I'm not.
Yeah, you are, by drinking that shit. You're encouraging them to kill butterflies.
This is just making me feel bad in my tummy.
Get something else.
It's just getting... No, it's almost done, so... I'll finish it. I'm taking one for the team. You're not going to finish all your Cheetos, but I'll finish this 80-ounce Bud Light.
I won't finish them on camera.
No, we're going to watch you in time-lapse. Time-lapse.
Number six.
Oh, God.
Food pills. Remember food pills? Remember everybody in the future said people are just going to have pills for food? There is an Oxycontin epidemic, but...
Are you just talking about Santa Claus Conquers the Martians?
No, that didn't influence me at all.
It might have.
It might have. I might have thought of it.
Mystery Science is live. Are you thinking like...
Well, can you imagine...
Willy Wonka.
Can you imagine a time where, like, you don't even bother actually eating the food? You just...
That's ridiculous. Well, they have, what, Soylent now? Where it's just like the flavorless... First of all, don't call it that.
I don't think anybody gets the joke, because I don't even know how that got...
Is it a joke?
A Kickstarter joke or something?
I don't know. I don't know anything about it. I know they had to recall a bunch of it, because people were getting real sick. But it's like, oh, a flavorless brick. This is all your food for the day.
Do you think that they didn't know what Soylent Green was, and then just decided that it was like, oh, it's like soy. It's made of soy, so we'll call it Soylent.
I mean, that's probably the pun that they went with. I don't know anything about it other than it sounds horrible.
You guys, it's people.
Food. Spoilies. Spoil some more movies. Go ahead.
I'd rather eat people than cockroaches, though.
What?
The train movie.
The train movie. Schindler's List.
Train movie.
Also Schindler's List.
Ooh.
Ooh. Yeah, there you go. Get your David Brent on. Keep playing with your time.
My Rodney Dangerfield.
Let me hear a Rodney Dangerfield.
No respect.
What is it, Rover Dangerfield? You ever see that? The cartoon?
No.
With him as the cartoon?
Yes! Oh my god! That was like a Saturday morning thing that happened for like 5 minutes.
No, it was a movie.
Was it a movie?
It was.
Okay, no.
It's not Don Bluth, but it was one of those...
No, it was. I was thinking of like Tiny Toons and Animaniacs. They used to do a lot of the cartoons of Rodney Dangerfield.
Well, that goes back to the old Warner Brothers making fun of Clark Gable and whatever.
Yeah.
Help me out.
Come on. Ow!
I just feel gross.
Whose fault is that? You don't have to drink all of it.
But I'm definitely going to drink all of it.
You're going to make me throw up.
Please don't.
Blah.
No, not in there. It's electric.
What's the train movie?
Are you being serious?
Yeah.
Do you not remember?
No! That's why I'm... Never mind. I don't
Schindler's
care.
Schindler's List.
Anyway.
I'm trying
food
to
pills, yes or no?
I think I'm trying to think of another movie with a train in it, and I can't. Besides the right one that you're looking for. I know that one. I'm trying to think of another movie with a train in it.
I don't care anymore.
French Bridge Over the River Kwai. Duh. Duh, you guys.
Wind Talkers.
Sir, train in that? Nicolas Cage? In the Indians?
Glazing Saddles. There's a train in that. Well, they're making a railroad.
They're making a railroad. I don't know if there's an actual train in it.
Oh my god. What's the name of the movie? Bullet Train to Snowville or whatever?
It's Bullet Train to Snowville! I'm gonna put a photoshopped, let me say what I'm gonna put on the screen. I'm gonna put a photoshopped movie poster of the movie she's talking about, but I'm gonna put, what was it? Bullet Train to Snowville? What was it called?
Yeah.
Bullet Train to Snowville! And movie star, Snow Train.
Starring Chris Evans.
You know the people! Oh, you're sweet on him.
No.
He's a super boy.
Is he? He fucks it up at the end.
No, I'm in general. He's a hero.
I can't think of the name.
It's Bullet Train to Snowville. Snowville Jamboree. Okay.
Yes or no to food pills?
We're still doing that!
Yes or no?
No! Correct. Part of the fun of food is enjoying
it.
It's the mouthfeel. That's not how you eat! You're throwing up on your food and then drinking it up. Like that movie? That guy's a bug now! Uh-oh!
What? What guy?
That movie. That's what? The name of the movie.
Movie?
That guy's a bug now! Uh-oh! I'm gonna Photoshop a movie poster of that actual movie with that fake title. I got so much
naked
work to do.
Naked Lunch?
Yeah. Naked Lunch! That guy's a bug now. Uh-oh! That's not the one I was thinking of, but that's pretty good, too.
Guy's a bug? What guy?
That guy's a bug now. Uh-oh!
You mean the train movie?
That guy's a train now. Uh-oh! Transformers 4.
Revenge of Shia.
Was he in 4? I don't think he was in 4.
I don't care.
I got sock coat out of my nose. That's not great.
Number 7.
It's getting wintry, you guys, so I'm real stiffly.
I cleaned all the mold out of the windowsills. Hopefully that'll help.
Oh, yeah, we got trippy windowsills.
Number 7. Girl Scout cookies.
Yes.
Really?
Yeah. Even you get... That's not long enough. There we go.
You get 5 of them for $9.
First of all, neither one of those is true. You get 6 for $8. So, yeah.
They're okay. They're okay.
Kate, of all the feminist
Even
things
the
you could be doing is
are...
buying cookies for these girls to learn how to start fires once the world ends.
I'm not saying I'm not buying them. I feel like... I'm just saying that they're overrated.
Like... No, I...
They're not that good.
I think everyone understands that they...
Oh, it's like the door-to-door chocolate that they used to sell. Like the generic chocolate. The generic chocolate
that you would buy because, I'll eat some chocolate right now.
It sits in a box because you agreed to do it and you think you're going to make a bunch of money.
And then
you
just
realize,
eat all of them.
And then you realize that you haven't sold any and you're like, fuck, I better eat all these and then just pay it. And then you make no money.
But it's like one of those things. It's like, I wish there was a chocolate boy coming around. Hey. Here's some chocolate.
I would buy some generic school chocolate.
I would. Now, we don't...
They used to do, they did M&M's eventually. But, the weird generic bars of chocolate.
I'm selling chocolate for my school. And we were going on a... Our band is going on a field trip. And then...
You still got that wrong, though.
I don't even remember what the question was.
Number 8.
Oh, no, that guy's a bug now. Is that okay or no?
What movie is that? Bullet Train?
No, that's a different movie.
I can't think of any bug movies. Metamorphosis?
Yeah. Metamorphosis, the movie.
Number 8.
10 minutes long.
Gold Leaf, like on food.
No, no.
Correct. That's fancy dumb bullshit.
We live in the town of fancy dumb bullshit.
But we can't afford fancy dumb bullshit, so no!
We make room in our budgets for fancy bullshit sometimes.
No, we make room in our budgets for this kind of shit. That kind of shit.
Yeah, that kind
and
of...
And then the occasional, trip to a brewing company to have dinner. And lots of drinks. Number 9. Rocky Mountain oysters.
Never had them.
Would you?
Yeah.
Why?
One of the things I said to myself, moving out to this town.
Is that you'd be up for trying
water? I'd be up for fucking...
Drop the pen.
I'd be up for anything. And that's the thing that I've stuck to.
Yeah. We could try more interesting things.
I've tried interesting things. I think the weirdest thing... Oh my god. I just knocked it over.
What's the weirdest thing you tried so far?
I had some head cheese, which I didn't...
Oh, right.
On that fucking...
Sandwich?
Torta. But I think I got into my own head about what it was, so I made myself sick.
Oh.
Because I got into my head like, oh, that's gross.
That's face fat.
Yeah, it's just like, let's melt a skull down and see what the juices are and then eat it.
Yeah, but it's like, think of it as like bacon fat.
You know, I got over it, and I ate it. It was good when I was eating it, and then I started thinking about it. I'm like, and then I got, ooh.
You didn't feel that way when you ate that weird tripe soup at the Vietnamese
The tripe soup was actually very good.
Really?
It was.
I would
it
be afraid that it
super
would be
good.
Dirty.
It wasn't just tripe, though. It was a bunch of other things. And if you go to a restaurant that serves foreign cuisine, go for it. Fucking go for it. Get something crazy. I mean, it's not crazy to them.
It says you don't have to drive home.
What does that mean?
I gotta drive home with a tummy ache. It's one thing to be able to just puke out the side.
Come on.
I gotta drive.
Why are you bringing that up?
Because that's pretty funny.
Go ahead.
No.
It's the food and drink episode. Go ahead and out me as a window puker.
Sorry.
Those couple of times that's happened in my life.
Hey, I was only there for one of them.
That's true.
You used to do a lot of puking.
I used to do a lot of puking, you guys.
Yeah.
Because of shit like this.
Yep.
Now I drink fancy beer, boys. Which are more expensive, so you can't drink as many.
Number 10.
Yeah.
Meringue? I even put a question mark next to it.
I mean, I've had it, and it's made no impression on me whatsoever.
Really?
I can't say yes or no. I know I've had it on several occasions, like in pies and such.
Right. That would be where I would assume you would have it.
You can have it on a plate, or in
just by itself?
Just in a spoon or whatever. Just make a little ice cream scoop full of it. I don't know. Yes?
Yeah, right.
The fact that I can't even tell you what or why should
like
tell you.
It's like egg whites, right?
It's,
like sugar?
Yeah, you're whipping it up. And yeah,
huh.
Whatever. Yeah.
Yeah, I go with yeah as well.
Yeah.
100%! No. 1, 2, 3. You got a 70.
That's the average for most of us.
Yeah, that's true. It's a 90 or, an 80 or 90 is rare.
Yeah, it can be.
It can be. It can be.
It can be. So,
else?
Yeah, so, we have it's hypothetical. Let's get it. We have a chef over there.
Where? A Jeff?
This is hypothetical.
Did you say a Jeff?
No, we have a chef with a teleportational device.
Ooh.
He's going to cook you whatever you want right now. You've been drinking, you're hungry, you have a chef who can cook anything in the fucking world.
Sorry about your shirt.
I knew that as soon as you put this white shirt on, it was going to be a mess.
Sorry.
Granted, I haven't worn this...
Since we got married.
Probably since our wedding. However many years ago that was.
Sure.
I know how many years it was. But yeah.
5 or 6.
5 or 6? It's definitely 6. So, you have a mystery chef.
Yeah.
Who knows everything. You've got an Iron Chef in there. Masaharu Morimoto is going to make you a meal.
Oh, wow.
What do you want? Right now.
Oh, God.
You're hungry. You got some drinks in you, so it's going to taste awesome no matter what it is.
Oh, God.
What is he going to make you right now?
With him, I probably...
No, I mean, I just use that as an example. But, yeah. You have Chef Boyardee in the kitchen right now.
More ravioli.
Guy Fieri is standing right over there.
Onion rings, obviously.
with
bacon on them.
Buffalo ranch.
Jizz.
Don't eat the jizz rings. That's the one thing I can say if you go to Guy Fieri's house. Don't eat the jizz rings.
Jeez, that's hard to say. I would probably make them give me...
What is a thing you cannot easily make or go get that you would like to have right now?
Some kind of fancy dessert. Because whatever to, like, whatever.
Yeah.
Like.
What do you want him to do?
Meringue. No, I would love to have, like, some sort of, like, souffle or something. I don't know.
You lost me.
What is the hardest thing that Gordon Ramsay ever wants you to make? It's a fucking souffle.
He wants risotto that's not garbage. Or a fucking scallop. That fucking show, those chefs can't cook.
No.
God damn it.
Well, they're baby chefs. That's why.
But they work in things. Why can't they cook a basic thing?
Some of them are
like...
I'm
not talking about MasterChef. I'm talking about Hell's Kitchen. These are supposed to be real people. I can't cook a scallop.
Right.
Fuck you. And scallops are fine. Why is that the meal they always cook?
Because they're probably hard.
They're...
To get right. That's probably why.
I guess.
Jeez. I would probably want... Okay, so if I had to get like an entree type thing...
Pretending you're getting the ingredients fresh.
Sure, sure.
From wherever they come from.
Handmade, hand-cut raviolis filled with 3 different kinds of cheese.
So, cream, cottage, and cheddar?
No. Like 3 different kinds of Italian cheeses. With herbs and spices.
Oh, sure.
And meatballs. Meatball ravioli.
Okay.
Fuck yeah. Because there's, like, I've had a couple times I've had fresh pasta.
Fresh pasta's really good.
Fucking amazing. It's really good. Love it.
Go to a fancy restaurant.
I'm a starch bitch, so.
A stitch? Okay, come on. Okay.
There's nothing there. Here. This will probably show
up. Oh, you didn't have it on. Okay, there. Oh, come on, ow! It's gritty. I thought you were really writing on me. I was going to let you.
There's nothing there.
I was going to let you. Well, the other pen didn't even show up.
I know. Well, when you walked by,
that's why that was got the biggest laugh of the day from yours truly.
I love your laughs.
That's what I live for. I live for laughs.
What would you get?
It's like a
hamburger?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Because you know what? Get some fucking Kobe beef and fucking sear some things and put a thing in it and do a thing and then
put some Tillamook cheddar.
Yeah, I can get that anywhere. I want something to surprise me.
Like 200-year-old aged cheddar?
Oh, I'll eat that.
Is that it really a fucking hamburger?
No, you said that.
What would you get?
I wouldn't want to know. I would give him free reign.
Oh, I didn't know there was a fucking option.
You didn't even ask.
That's not fair.
Give me something. I don't know what it
is. Plus, you gave me Guy Fieri.
I didn't give him to you.
So he would have just been.
You were like, I want a side of jizz rings. So you went for it. That's you. Don't eat the jizz rings.
Whatever.
We've been over this.
Whatever.
Don't eat the jizz rings.
But I don't want to be rude.
I've had most things.
You've had most things?
Let's pretend.
Bullshit.
Let's pretend.
Bullshit.
Let's pretend that I have in my 400 years of life. Rounding up. Yeah, give me something there. Here's the thing.
I would do that too.
No, you already said you want jizz rings and ravioli.
Whatever. Anyway, what's next?
That's it. That's what I'm starting.
No, do you want a top five? I have a
top
five for you.
No, we don't know what next week is yet.
Oh, okay. Because I thought of it. Top five, that would be fun. Okay, here's an
next
idea.
Week.
Okay, I have a one-off, like you just did.
What? Yeah, go ahead.
What did you...
We still got battery.
If you've...
They've already turned this off.
Whatever. So, you see something that you want to eat, because it looks really, really good. And then you try it, and it was terrible. Mm-hmm. What was that thing?
That's been a bunch of things.
Name one.
I don't know.
Name the most recent.
No, that weird sushi I had at the restaurant was
gross. I think that had, like, sweet bean paste on it.
I don't know what it was. I don't know. For some reason, I thought it was a weird piece of chicken. Because this fucking... This buffet we went to yesterday... Was it yesterday? Mm-hmm. I guess it was yesterday. Had... Oh, here's... here's Chinese food, and then here's sushi, but we also have pizza and chicken nuggets and french fries. And
For kids.
Fucking everything. So I thought they were doing some weird fusion shit, where it's like, oh, here's a piece of buffalo chicken on a piece of sushi, which is crazy. I would eat it.
I could see that as being possibly good.
Being where we're at in this weird fusion town we're in.
We went to a regular trash Chinese buffet.
We went to a trash buffet, and that was great.
That guy with the prawns was amazing. This guy. He had a fucking tower of, like, prawn shells. He was just eating fucking prawns. Not shrimp, prawns.
Prawns are fine. They're fine.
They have faces. The shrimp at least don't have faces.
Most things have faces.
At some point.
Yeah.
But after cooking?
Yeah.
Mm.
Fish? Fish have faces?
Not the ones I ate.
You ever eat a whole fish?
No. But I would.
That's what I'm saying. I've eaten most things.
I'll
eat a fish face.
I want a fish.
I want a
salt cured fish.
I'll eat a pig face.
I won't eat a pig face. I've been to a luau. I won't eat a cow face.
Oh, eat the cheeks. Cheek them up. Eyeball. Eat an eyeball.
Nope. I don't think so. Sorry.
That's the thing you won't eat. Eyeballs or cheeks?
I don't want to eat either of those things.
Okay. You're closing yourself out from refreshment.
It'd be one of those things where it's like, if I didn't know what it was and I tried it and I liked it, then I'd be fine with it. But like if I put it in my mouth and like I was, like you said with the fucking head cheese, you're all like, ew, I was thinking about it in my head and then it made me weirded out or whatever. Like if I don't know what it is and I put it in my mouth and it's really good, then I'll be fine.
But wouldn't it be worse if you get something and you don't know what it is and then you end up liking it and then you hear later what it is and then you're like, oh, now I gotta seek that out?
No, that's fine, because then my fear has been conquered. It's the initial, like, texture in my mouth where I feel like I might throw up.
You're weird about textures, though.
Yeah. That's true.
Like, abnormal.
Mm-hmm.
Let's talk about it.
I don't like cake.
You don't like cake. Every birthday is ruined.
No. There's always ice cream cake. I just don't eat the cake part.
I want a pie!
Yeah, or a pie. There's cookie cakes.
You know what? I don't even like cookie cakes. I'm gonna be honest with you.
I like cookie cakes.
I don't even think I do.
Well, too bad. I like the frosting anyway. It's the frosting for
me. Just get you a tin of frosting and put a candle in it.
Give me an organic tin of frosting.
Oh, they do not have organic frosting. Get the fuck out of here.
Make me some then. We have a little food processor.
You know what it is? It's going to be a pile of beets. It's not even going to be a real thing.
Beets?
Yeah, because your beet sugar or whatever is in your other bullshit.
Oh, that's a candy. No, yeah. There's no beet sugar. They use that for the coloring.
Beet sugar? What do they call it?
Beetroot.
What are they called? Beet sugar.
Boogers.
Bringo.
You're disgusting. You disgust me.
I don't feel good.
Here, have some ginger.
No.
It'll make you feel better.
No, I felt worse last week when I drank all my drinks and then drank your drinks too. So I'm not doing that this week.
This is ginger though. It'll make your tummy feel better.
And worse.
Got Cheeto dust on you.
I do. That's okay. Most of those Cheetos are going to go inside of me.
Yeah.
Since you're over it.
They're not that great.
You're wrong.
I don't even remember them being that, like, I don't know what it was.
They're poppable.
It's like my childhood. That's what it is. It's more just that it was in my parents' pantry all the time. So, like, they were there. And when I started getting high at, like, 16, they were there. They were there for me. Gross.
Sorry.
No, you're not.
That's mixing with that, which is mixing with whatever.
Whatever else you ate.
So
chili.
Oh, hey, burps if you're lucky.
Got some zip zaps out there? What are you doing?
I just want you to peek out the window at a stranger in the parking lot and spook him.
Walk out to my car. Hey, what's up?
Hey, what's up, guys?
Hey, guys.
I'm a fashion plate.
I'm a fashion plate.
Should have had you go get the mail. With that on. With this. Get up. You're in the office. You have a package. I'm training at Mary Kay. What do you think?
Would you guys like to buy some cosmetics?
Avon calling.
Give me that pink Cadillac.
We did it.
Hooray. Here.
Yo, you are cleaning. I'm gonna hose you up in the fucking yard. You're a mess.
Have a good night.
So bye.
Goodbye.
Can I finish?
I'm out of here.
Can I finish? Thank you. Guys, thanks for joining us for another fun-filled episode.
Hopefully I'll have the rest of this tutorial
of
figured out.
Yeah, keep that on your face all week.
Okay.
And then next week, show us how
I'll
it turns
it
out.
Try.
Makes you look like a cool vampire.
Ooh, vampires are in this season.
I think they've been out for a long time.
Sparkles.
No?
No.
So guys, go to lifeouttaffy.com for our contact info and for goodies.
Ooh, there might be some goodies.
There might be some goodies. Check it out. God damn it. Every Monday, a brand new episode. Next week, who knows?
We don't know.
What is it going to be about? I don't know. We're counting down the last couple episodes of season one of Life Without Taffy show.
A couple of weeks.
Yeah. Start of the new year, it's going to be season two. Who knows what's going to happen then? So we're gonna get weird these next couple episodes, guys. So stick with us if you want the four people watching this.
You should.
Thank you. Thank you for everybody who's given it a like and sharing it with your friends. We appreciate it. Send your emails to us, your requests.
To him. Send them to him.
Well, I mean,
send them to
everybody. Go to lifewithouttaffy.com. Like I said, get our contact info.
Send us some stuff.
Send it, yeah.
We love hearing
what do you
from
wanna
you.
See? What do you want to see? Is it this?
I bet it's more of this.
I'm going to zoom into that.
Zoom in!
And then I'm going to fade out on your cool face. Is that okay? Can I do that?
Yeah.
Oh, God.
Hurry up. This doesn't feel good.
What doesn't feel good? My tummy doesn't feel good. How far should I zoom? All the way? How about that far?
I don't know.
Keep your eyes open. Quit moving.
Not moving.
Stop! Put your head back up. I was on your eyeball. There we go. Wider. Wider.
I can't do it anymore.
Do it wide! There you go. Fade out.
Ooh.
No, keep it open. I'm not done. Fading. That's the look. Okay, stay there. 10. Count down from 10.
I can't. It hurts my eyes too much.
Count down. You can't keep your eyes.
Not crossed like that.
No, I'm just on one eye, so you can do whatever you want. No, the other eye. This eye.